everyone. This is Paolo Puac-Polanco from the University of Ottawa. I will be presenting this interesting case of an oligodendroglioma published in the RSNA Case Collection in April last year. This was a collaborative work that we did with our colleagues in Chile. This is a case of a previously healthy 56-year-old male presented to the ED with a new onset of partial left motor seizures. 3 months before presentation, he reported a mild traumatic brain injury. In the following weeks to this event, he started complaining of headaches that resolved with medication. On the day of presentation, the patient was at home when he had a witnessed seizure and was brought to the ED. An MRI of the brain was performed. This is a T2 sequence on axial plane to your left and coronal plane to your right. There is an intraaxial mass depicted by the arrows on axial plane involving the right insula, the frontal operculum, and the anterior temporal lobe. The lesion shows ill-defined margins, a small cystic component, and mild mass effect on the surrounding structures, which is better appreciated on the coronal image. There were associated calcifications within the mass depicted by the yellow arrow on CT to your left, corresponding to the areas of lumen artifact on the gradient echo image to your right. T1 post-contrast sequence, the image to your far left, shows faint linear enhancement within the mass. MR perfusion, the middle image, shows increased areas of high serial blood volume. The image to your far right is a DWI map where we can see a mismatch between MR perfusion and DWI. The areas of high perfusion within the mass do not show reduced restricted diffusion. MR spectroscopy shows an increase of the choline peak depicted by the white arrow and decreased NAA depicted by the yellow arrow in keeping with an abnormal increased choline NAA ratio. The final pathology revealed an oligodendroglioma IDH-mutant 1P19Q codylated WHO grade 2. The key diagnostic features of this case were the corical-subcortical infiltrative pattern of growth, the presence of coarse calcifications, and the patient's young age. The differential diagnoses include other primary brain tumors such as ganglioglioma, low-grade astrocytoma, and DNET. Oligodendrogliomas represent 5 to 10% of all primary intracranial neoplasms. According to the last WHO classification, they are defined by the presence of 1P19Q codeletion and IDA mutation. The majority of them are supratentorial tumors, being the frontal lobe the most common location. Regarding imaging, oligodendrogliomas are solid tumors that involve the cortex and subcortical white matter with minimal or absent surrounding vasogenic edema. The presence of coarse calcifications is one of the hallmarks of these tumors. However, this is variable and can be found in 20 to 90% of the cases. MR perfusion often shows areas of increased CBV mimicking a high-grade tumor. However, this increased perfusion does not correlate with high grade on histopathology examination. Regarding prognosis and treatment, gross total resection is the first line therapy. Radiation therapy is reserved for tumors that do not respond to conventional treatment. The survival rate of these tumors is variable at 5 and 10 years that depends on the tumor grade, patient's age, and response to treatment. This patient in particular had a gross total resection of the lesion. He underwent a second resection of a recurrent non-enhancing lesion 6 years after the initial surgery, in addition to radiation therapy and chemotherapy. Currently, he has had a stable disease for the last 2 years. We thank the RSNA Case Collection for the invitation to participate. Thank you.